The statistical tests are used to evaluate the significance of the critical difference and relationship hypothesis from the measure phase. In the case of significant results, we will also decide on the practical relevance of their impact strength. Since we identify triggers of the problems in the input and process mapping analysis, significant and relevant results from the hypothesis tests can serve as starting points for the root cause analysis. The first hypothesis states there is a or no difference in the rating of taste between different cookie types. To distinguish between the cookie types and then focus on the corresponding output with a bigger problem, I choose the two-sample t-test, although the data is only ordinally scaled and not normally distributed. The Wilcoxon-Mann-Whitney test is suitable here without restrictions, but the t-test is quite robust against violations of these conditions. We obtain a significant result with a p-value smaller than 0.001 related to the significance level of alpha 0.05, i.e. 5%. The calculated probability of error is therefore smaller than the previously determined typical significance level alpha, and therefore we reject the null hypothesis, there is no difference, and accept the alternative hypothesis, there is a difference. The statistics table shows the size of our sample, the mean values for chocolate and vanilla cookies, and the 95% confidence intervals for the means. The true mean value mu in the population of all chocolate and vanilla cookies is therefore expected with a 95% probability within the limits of the respective confidence intervals. These confidence intervals are determined by the accepted alpha and beta errors, the sample size, and the standard deviation. The next result shows a difference of 1.52 between the means of the ratings and the surrounding 95% confidence intervals for this difference, of 1.16 to 1.88. We therefore expect, with a 95% confidence, that the mean difference in the population lies within this interval. The statistical significance of the test results from the fact that this confidence interval does not include the difference equals zero, as postulated in H0. Therefore, we reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternative hypothesis. The interval plot graphically illustrates this result. The x-axis shows a vertical line at the difference equals zero, the calculated difference between the means for chocolate and vanilla cookies, as well as the surrounding confidence interval. Here it becomes clear that the difference equals zero lies outside the confidence interval, i.e. a difference equals zero is not expected. Instead, we expect at least a difference of 1.16 and in the worst case a difference of 1.88 between the ratings. Is this statistically significant difference between the cookie types also relevant for our bakery? Is it important for us in practice that chocolate cookies are rated at least one rating point lower and on average 1.5 lower on a six-step rating scale? Let me explain the question using another example. Imagine we had only found a difference between the ratings of 0.01 points on the scale. This small difference would not become significant for our sample size of n equals 100, and we would keep the null hypothesis that there is no difference. With the statistics tool Power and Sample Size, I calculated that with a sample size of n equals 226,000, this difference would become significant for the given standard deviation and the same alpha and beta errors. So we would have shown a very small difference, this time based on a very large sample, statistically significant, and would also reject the H0 and assume the HA. But in practice, this small difference probably has no relevance. It is irrelevant in practice that one cookie type is rated on average with 2 points and another cookie type with 2.01 points. Therefore, you should always ask yourself if you get a statistically significant result, if the difference is relevant for your practice. Does a difference have a practical relevance even if you base it on the lowest expected difference value of the confidence interval, which is 1.16 in our case? We will continue this topic in the relationship hypothesis as well as in the control phase when it comes to proving a before-after difference. Here I would like to summarize for the moment that a statistical significance informs us about the resilience of the hypothesis in the future, that in the future we will find a similar difference under similar conditions. And we can only answer the question of the practical relevance if we assess the importance of a certain significant difference or relationship for our further analysis and thus for our company or our customers. In our case, we think that the result should have consequences. If we change nothing, then with a probability of 95%, the chocolate cookies will also in future be rated at least 1.15 grades worse than the vanilla cookies. And we can already include this result in our root cause analysis. Our primary problem we had defined in the define phase is Y1 cookie tastes bad. Now we can differentiate between the cookie types and we will focus on the bad taste of chocolate cookies. The differentiation we have uncovered is not yet a cause of our problem, but a specification. In the following, we will only deal with chocolate cookies and exclude vanilla cookies from further analysis. They have no problem. The histograms finally show the separated distributions of the ratings for both cookie types, with the respective means and the confidence intervals around the means. The second hypothesis states there is a relationship between the amount of chocolate in a cookie and the rating of their taste. To investigate the modeled assumption about the causal determination of the taste of a chocolate cookie by the amount of chocolate in that cookie, I choose the general regression to statistically test the associated relationship hypothesis. The rank correlation would be more suitable for ordinal scaled and not normally distributed ratings, but the regression analysis can better demonstrate the purpose of the hypothesis and its test. For this reason, however, the results must be interpreted with reservations. First, we get again a significant result with a p-value smaller 0.001 at a predetermined 5% significance level alpha. The fitted line plot, a scatter plot with a regression line, shows the negative relationship between the amount of chocolate in the cookie and the rating of its taste. The more chocolate in a cookie, the lower the grade value, meaning the better the rating. The regression equation expresses this relationship numerically. With this equation, Y chocolate cookie taste equals 6.4 minus 0.57 times weight of chocolate, we could forecast the taste rating based on the amount of chocolate in a cookie. Every regression analysis leads to such a regression equation. But how accurate is such a prediction? How well can we rely on it? This again is a question of the practical relevance. We got a significant result, but only the determination coefficient, R squared, expresses the benefit of the result. In our case, R squared is 96.51% and thus very high. It means that by varying the amount of chocolate within the selected range, about 97% of the taste variability can be explained. In other words, the taste rating of a cookie is determined to 97% by the amount of chocolate in that cookie. For our bakery, we thus have found a strong, practically relevant cause for the rating of the taste. And of course, I consider this cause in our root cause analysis. Why is a chocolate cookie rated bad? Because the amount of chocolate is too low. Or more precise, the lower the amount of chocolate, the worse the taste. The determination coefficient, R squared, simplified for our case of 1x and 1y, results from squaring of the correlation coefficient. This correlation, in our case a high negative correlation, minus 0.98, is shown in the last graph. It quantifies the pattern of the fitted line plot and leads to the R squared value of 97%. And of course, there are also confidence intervals for correlation coefficients and the derived determination coefficients. But these are not specified in this summary. There are different opinions on the size of the determination coefficient, of above which it has a practical relevance. It is often expressed that R squared should be greater than 0.80, and therefore the correlation would have to be greater than 0.89. This requirement is basically appropriate for mechanical or automated production. However, different conditions apply to services whose processes are subject to the variability of human activities. I can recall a case of a high cancellation rate of employees in a company's shops. We have searched intensively, but only found one significant correlation of 0.45 with a workload due to increased customer volumes at certain times of the year. Nevertheless, the resulting determination of R squared equals 20% had a practical relevance for us in the subsequent root cause analysis, because we had only a few and very weak explanations for the cancellation rate. So if we don't know better, then a 20% determination is better than guessing. As with the difference hypothesis, we can only decide subjectively on the practical relevance of a relationship. The third hypothesis states, there is a difference in the taste of a chocolate cookie between the condition the chef eats the already weighed chocolate from the ingredients versus not. Again, I choose the two-sample t-test, although not all conditions for this test are fulfilled here. And we again obtain a significant result with a p-value smaller 0.001. The statistics show a mean value of 4.6 if our chef nibbles chocolate from the ingredients, and if our chef does not nibble on the chocolate, then a mean value of 1.5 results. The difference between the ratings under these two conditions is thus 3.1. The expected true difference in the population lies with a 95% confidence in the interval between 3.45 and 2.75. If our chef nibbles on the chocolate from the ingredients, then the cookies will be rated at least 2.75 points worse, and this significant result, of course, also has a practical relevance for us. The interval plot illustrates this result again graphically, with a vertical line at the difference equals 0, which should apply if the null hypothesis is valid, and the calculated difference between the two conditions with the surrounding confidence interval. The histograms finally show the separated distributions of the ratings under the conditions, with the respective means and the confidence intervals around the means. The result of this difference hypothesis provides a cause for the different amount of chocolate in the cookies. Why does the amount of chocolate vary in the cookies? Because our chef nibbles chocolate from the weighed ingredients. Or vice versa, if our chef nibbles chocolate from the ingredients, then the amount of chocolate in the cookies is reduced. Since we have no data about why our chef nibbles chocolate from the ingredients, we are now again dependent on the opinion of the experts. But of course we already have an assumption why that is. Our next task is to combine the statistical results with considerations of the experts in a root cause analysis.